Good morning, everyone. I'm back again. So, in the last session, we have talked about the types of the government we have. So, the main forms or main types of the government is democracy, monarchy, and the dictatorship. I hope everyone has understood the last session. So, in this session, we are going to talk about the features of democracy. Why only the features of democracy? You live in India and all of you know that India is a democratic country. So we are going to read about the features of the democracy. The first one, rule by people. The basic idea of a democracy is that people rule themselves by participating in the making of these rules. What does this mean? That what is the basic idea of this democracy? What does this democracy is all about? So in features, it is going to help us to understand democracy in a better way. How? Like the first feature says that rule by people. Since I have told you that democracy is what? If I am talking about democracy, it means it is by the people, for the people, and from the people, which means the government that is made by the people. How by the people? Means we, the citizens of a country, gives the vote. Elections are done. They vote for the their favorite candidate, and according to that, the majority vote, the party who gets the majority vote is chosen as our government. So the first one is by the government. How by the government? Because we only elect the our government. We give them vote, and according to that, our government is made. Okay, then for the people. Now, why these elections are held, why government is made? Government is there to look after the country, as in they take care that if whether they make the rules for the country, they make sure that everything is going in a proper manner in the country, like no one is having any kind of disputes, if there is any, so they try to resolve that, and everyone is following the rules and regulations, and if not, they get the punishments also, or as or whatever the fines or things are there decided for that. So first one is by the people. We elect them, we give them vote. Through that voting, the government is made, and after that, that government makes the rule for the country, that everyone has to follow those rules. And now from the people, what does this mean? That this government, the people who are elected or who, the people who stand in the elections come from where? They are from us only. Either one of us is a part of our government only. They don't come from any other place or any other country. They are a part of a country only. So that means a democracy is a government which is by the people, for the people, and from the people. So the first features also says that it is ruled by the people. This means that the rules are not something that government made. Like we have given the power. We have given the power to elect their rulers or leaders. We got the power. Suppose we have the power to elect our leaders. Since we have elected our leaders, you have elected your leaders. So we have given them power that they will together, they will make rules for us. So in short or indirectly, we are responsible for our government only because we have given them vote, and we have so much trust in them that they will
better handle our country. So in this way, that means rule by the people. So the basic idea of a democracy is that people rule themselves by participating in the making of these rules. How people participates in making the rules? As how we get this participation, how we participate in that? We participate by choosing our candidates. We choose our candidates. We give them vote. According to our vote, only the government is formed. No one from the other countries come and make our government. So that rule, that power we are getting to choose our government or choose our rulers or leaders means that we are getting the power to make the rules. So it is basically democracy is a rule by the people only. We are the one only who are making the rules. Then representative democracy. Democracy is usually meant as representative democracy. What does this mean? That people do not participate directly in the government but choose their representative through an election process. And further, these representative sitting together make decision for the entire population of the country. So what does this mean? That we don't participate directly, that we will form the government or we will make the decision. What we do, we indirectly participate in that. How indirectly? We choose our representative. Hum apne representative choose karte hain through the process of elections. There are elections after every 5 years. After every 5 years, our government is changed. So these representatives are chosen by us only. So we choose our representatives through the process of election, and then the representative which are elected through this election process, they together sit and they together make the decisions. Like first we have decided who will make the decision, then they together come and they form a group and then they make the decision for the whole country, and the whole country has to follow those rules. So next point, universal adult franchise. It means all adults in the country are allowed to vote. This is very essential feature of a democracy. Like no government can claim itself to be a democratic government without allowing all adults to vote. It means that कोई भी गवर्नमेंट क्लेम नहीं कर सकती खुद को डेमोक्रेटिक. नो गवर्नमेंट कैन क्लेम देमसेल्स डेमोक्रेटिक विदाउट अलाउइंग अ अडल्ट्स टू वोट. सपोज इफ इन अ कंट्री अडल्ट्स आर नॉट अलाउड टू वोट, व्हाट डज दैट मीन्स? दैट दे आर नॉट गिविंग अस द राइट, गिविंग अस द फ्रीडम. सो व्हेन वी आर नॉट गेटिंग एनी फ्रीडम और राइट्स, देन हाउ डज इट इवन कॉल एज अ डेमोक्रेसी, डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री? So it means if you are following a democratic government, you are having a democratic government, it means you are also allowing adults to vote, all the adults to vote. In the earliest time, if I talk about the earlier time, the democracies of the world was like only men who had certain level of property and education were allowed to vote by the governments. That is, the poor and the women and uneducated persons were not allowed to vote. In a current scenario, everyone can vote, like of any caste or any religion can vote in a country. You have to be a citizen of a country and you can vote. Above the age of 18, a person above the age of 18 is considered as an adult person. So any person who is above the age of 18 years is an adult, and they have the right to vote in elections, which means whether you are woman, whether you are poor, whether you are uneducated, or anything you can think of, you can vote if you are above the age of 18 years and you are a citizen of a country. Also, in the earlier time, if you are a woman, you cannot vote. If you are poor, you cannot vote. If you are uneducated, you cannot vote. I am talking about the earlier time democracy. Earlier time, the governments which are having a democratic government used to follow this thing, that only some people, only the men of a good society. Good society means a higher society, as in who have a some specific amount of property they have, some specific level of education they have, like educated people, and moreover the healthy, wealthy peoples also, who has a certain amount of wealth and also a certain level of education they have. So only those men are allowed to vote in the earlier time. But now everyone can vote. So this is the difference between the earlier time the democracy we are following and now we are following. So you can see that in the earlier time we are following this rules, like only certain men are allowed to vote. So do you think this is really a democracy when only some part of the society is getting the right to vote? No, this is not a democratic form of government. So when I talk about a democracy, these are the very main features of the democracy, that representative democracy, ruled by the people, and universal adult franchise. Ruled by the people means we only participate in making those rules. How? By selecting our representatives. Then representative democracy means that we only elect, we only vote for our representative, we only choose our representatives, and those representatives we have choose, they then together sit and they take decisions for the whole country. Then the third one, universal adult franchise. This will follow now all over the world, not just in the India only, but all over the world wheresoever democracy is. So universal adult franchise is it that all the adults means persons above the age of 18 years, all the adults has the right to vote, which means any person who is above the age of 18 can vote in the elections and can choose their representative according to their choice. No pressure on them, and not like the earlier times only men can vote. Whether you are a woman, you are poor, you are uneducated, or anything else, senior citizen, or anything XYZ option you think of. So anyone can take part in this elections. But the only thing you need to have is you should be a citizen of the country. Only then you can take part here. So these was all the main features of the democracy. Now we will move forward. Now this is the last topic in our government topic, the last subtopic in our government topic, that is the levels of the government. So there are three levels of the government in India, that is the local level, state level, and the national level. First of all, the local government level. So first one is the local level. The government in India, or the government in a village, town, or a locality is known as a local government. This local government deals with the problems faced by the local people. Local people means like the people living in the village, town, or particular locality. And the example of these governments are like panchayati system,
Then we have this Zilla Parishad. Zilla Parishad. Municipal Committee or Municipal Corporation. Corporation or Committee. These are some of the examples of the local level. The government at the local level takes care or deals the problem with the problem faced by the people living in that particular area village. And the government examples of those governments are panchayati system. Like in the villages we have a panchayat. So panchayat deals with any problem faced by the people living in that village. Any kind of dispute, any personal dispute or something else also, like you, whether it's dispute between a family or the neighbors or any person living in that village, those problems are solved by the panchayati system. Same way the Zilla Parishad, it belongs to a particular Zilla. So any problem that is coming under the Zilla Parishad, they solve those problems. It deals with that kind of things which is related to their Zilla. Every village has their own panchayat system. Whether you live in a very small area, small locality, or whether you live in a very big city or a very big country, there we have a government at every level. So any problem faced by you, the government can solve your problem, as they have various levels to solve your problem. If your problem is not solved at one level, you can go to the other level and then to the next level also. Then the second part is state level. The government at the state level is called the state government. State level means these governments deals with the issue related to the whole state. Like we live in Delhi. So the state government of Delhi will take care about the issues related to the Delhi or any other state like Haryana. So Haryana government will take care of that. Same way the Punjab government, the Bihar government, the Gujarat government. So every state has their own government. Like every village has their panchayats. Jilla Parishad is also there for the each Jilla. The same way every state has their own government. Then we have the national level. The government at the national level is known as the national government or the central government or the union government. If I talk about the national level, means it is the national government as in India. So the Indian government, if I talk about the Indian government, that means it is the national level government. It is the central government or the union government. This government deals with the issues related to the entire country, not just one village, not just one state, but the entire country. So we have a three forms of the government, that is the local level, state level and the national level. The government works at the all three levels. The first one is the local level, that is the village, town or the locality, whereas the state level, every state has their own government. Delhi, Haryana, Delhi has Delhi government, Haryana government, Gujarat government, Punjab government. So every state has their own government. If I talk about national level, that means I'm talking about a country. I'm talking about at country's entire level, which means we have the Indian government, and India government means the government at the national level. It is also known as the central government or the union government. Union, why union? Because it is formed with the union of the members. Union of the members means the representative that are elected by the people of the country only, that are chosen by the people of the country. The local level deals with the problems faced by the people living in that area, the local area, that is village, town or their locality. If I talk about state, it means they deal with all kinds of issues related to the state. एक स्टेट से रिलेटेड जो भी उनके इश्यूज होंगे वो उससे डील करेगी. इट डील्स विद द ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ इश्यूज रिलेटेड टू अ पर्टिकुलर स्टेट. लाइक इफ आई टॉक अबाउट पंजाब, सो इफ देयर इज एनी काइंड ऑफ इशू रिलेटेड टू एनीथिंग, वेदर हेल्थ इशू, एजुकेशन इशूज और एनी ट्रांसपोर्ट इशू, सो द पंजाब गवर्नमेंट विल डील विद दैट. देन द नेशनल लेवल, इंडियन गवर्नमेंट. लाइक यू कैन सी दैट now also we are having this lockdown situation. So in this situation, who has taken this decision for the whole country? The central government, the Indian government, has decided that there will be a lockdown for this much days. So it means that the national level government, the Indian government, works for the entire country, issues related to the entire country, because this coronavirus is not just for Delhi or Punjab or Haryana or one particular area. It is for the whole country, even not for the whole country but for the whole world. So that is why the central government has decided this lockdown. So this was about the levels of the government, and now our government topic is completed. Now in the next session we'll start with the new topic. I hope everyone has understood this, and also start doing your homework on time. Make a separate notebook, keep writing the notes, and also do install that Snap homework application, because all your homeworks will be posted there now. And from the next session I'll start with your 8th class topics. So that's all for today. Thank you and take care.